Valentino Rossi heading up the second row of the grid. It's an all Yamaha second row, and Lorenzo would have been rallying the troops, I'm sure, to try and get those Yamaha bikes in between himself and Marquez. You can see six podium finishes this season, including the win at Assen. It's been a decent enough comeback for Rossi. He will make that major shock of a change before the start of next season, replacing JB in the crew. And for him, I suppose it's a roll of the dice to see, look, if we just change one element, is that going to be able to bring me right back to be able to battle these youngsters?
Guys, I'm just down here with Massimo Merigali. Massimo, in Japan, you said, don't ask me about tyres. Is it the same today?
Again. No, OK, we choose for the good one, I hope.
And what's the tactic going to be? Get out front or stay behind Marquez and try and rough him up a bit?
At the moment, the target is only one, try to win the title.
Great, thank you very much, Massimo.
Yeah, he's a great help, wasn't he? But quite right, excellent performance by Bradley Smith qualifying on that second row of the grid. It's six fastest and a former winner here, of course.
I think
you saw
from that graph there as well the progression that he's made and consistency in finishing towards the second half of the season. He's going to look forward to testing tomorrow when he gets basically the latest spec bike from Yamaha, as with Paul Espargaro. There's Jeremy McGrath down there, big hero actually of Valentino Rossi, multi-supercross, motocross champion in the States, of course. Yeah. And Rossi always has him as one of his big heroes from when he's watched motorcycle racing.
He's beaming in some big events, a big stadium event.
But a lot of stadiums. It's like a supercross event, this almost,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah, it is, but I wouldn't think he's felt one like this for a long, long time.
There's Alvaro Bautista, who's heading up the third row of the grid in seventh place. All right, Alvaro, I think that's not where you put the earplug, definitely. But hasn't had a podium this season. I'm not sure he's going to be that close to one today unless something dramatic happens. But remember, he was involved in that incident at Turn 1 here a couple of years ago, and it just shows that things can happen. Running down towards Turn 1, a fast entry into that corner at the track.
Stefan Bradley won the Moto2 world title here when he actually crashed out in the race, but Marc Márquez couldn't start the race and shook his hand before the race got underway, qualifying got underway, to congratulate him on being the world champion a couple of years ago. Fought back really well after that horrible injury 4 weeks ago when we were at Sepang in Malaysia. Here is Cal Crutchlow. What a rider, what a season it's been by him. Of course, signing off for Yamaha with a fifth place in the championship.
Guys, I'm just moving away from motorcycling just a little bit. I'm down here with Felix Baumgartner, who you might know from setting an incredible record, jumping from an incredibly high height. Felix, here at MotoGP, what do you make of these guys on these incredibly powerful machines?
Well, I do have a lot of respect because I've been walking around since 2 days talking to pretty much everyone, you know, and the technique that's involved is incredible, you know. It's fast, it's a lot of power, and it's really, really difficult for these guys to compete on a racetrack. They're all there at once, you know, and everybody's trying to win. So I have to say, wow, because I know how to ride a motorcycle a little bit, but these guys definitely top of their game.
You yourself have a record-breaking mindset. We know that Marc Márquez could make history today. What, from your point of view, what goes through your mind when you're about to start such a historic event?
Well, I can barely imagine, but it's always, you got to be so focused, you got to be determined. You have to have confidence in your team, in your skills, and your technique. And if all of these three things are balanced, you're going to be successful.
And who do you think is going to be winning the race today?
I guess it's Marc Márquez.
Great. Thank you very much for your time.
Yeah, it's basically what he said was right there, one professional sportsman to another. So Marc Márquez is picked, but Jorge Lorenzo won't like that one. He's got to do the business today. He knows about doing the business. Of course, world champion twice in MotoGP, twice in the 250cc class. Put together a brilliant season all in all. On that bike, to have won seven races, more than anybody else. Brilliant, brilliant performance.
Yeah, especially with the two crashes, of course, in Assen and the one in the Saxon Ring that broke his collarbone. He was the winner here in 2010, but he missed the race in 2011 and crashed in the race last year while he was in the lead. He would be the first Spanish rider to retain the Premier Class title.
Yeah, of course, Crivier never managed it, and he didn't manage it when he first won it back in 2010.
Of course, the old circuit announcer, he won't be whipping the crowd up in any way.
No.
Totally, just having a quiet afternoon. Woof. Big David Nicky Hayden, his last ride for Ducati.
Yeah, he's got other pastures to look forward to now, riding for the Aspar team and that Honda customer racer next year. He says he's so looking forward to that. However, they do still need to have one final go at it for Ducati. They must be right on the limit of their engines as well, as we watch the Mexican wave going around the track. They're having some fun up there on the grandstands.
11th fastest alongside Nicky Hayden on that fourth row of the grid. Andrea Noni second here 3 years ago in the Moto2 race, 12th in the World Championship. Difficult first season for him. And Danilo Petrucci had a brilliant qualifying, didn't he?
Yeah, first time this season that he's been top CRT. We don't know what he's going to be doing next year. I expect there's a few people with their eyes on him for a ride next year. I wonder if Iota will be able to stick around and keep him in their ranks. Brilliant atmosphere, everyone joining in on that Mexican wave, whether you're a Marquez or a Lorenzo fan. We've just been handed the tyre sheet by Bridgestone, and so many last minute crosses and ticks here and there, but the basic thing that we're seeing is it looks like the top riders are all going for that harder option tyre. And we saw yesterday in the free practice, Nick, how consistent, for example, Lorenzo was on that new spec rubber that Bridgestone have brought here this weekend.
Yeah, it was a 30-minute session, wasn't it, before qualifying. Boy, did he knock in some... I think he did 15 laps, didn't he?
Of 20 laps out of real, what will be 30 today.
Real race pace. Very impressive indeed, before he had his problems in qualifying. So we wait and see.
Guys, just moving away from the championship battle, talking about maybe Cal Crutchlow. I'm down here with Hervé Poncharal. Hervé, is this an emotional day for you, last race with Cal?
Ah, for sure. You know, you can see on the back of his helmet, there is a hand saying, you know, waving to say bye-bye. We had a small party last night all together, and it was quite emotional. But you know, we know for quite a while, so we knew there would be an end. The end is now. It would be like a fairy tale to end up on a strong result. You know, a podium could be, you know, is a possibility with third this morning in the warm up. It feels good, but it's going to be tough. Anyway, you know, we have to move on. I want to thank him again for what he's done with us. Wish him good luck where he's going. And, you know, from tomorrow, this is 14, and we'll start with the new lineup. So, you know, just enjoy the battle today. Hope Cal will be there and without disturbing anything. And this is a great day today. The crowd is incredible. The weather is perfect for this time of the year. So everybody's happy. And I hope also for, you know, Tech 3, Monster Yamaha, this is going to be a great end of the championship.
Great. Thank you very much, Hervé.
Yeah, been a remarkable clear by career by Cal Crutchlow. His last podium did come in Germany, off the boil just a little bit, a lot of injuries. Fourth in the race here in 2011, which clinched him the Rookie of the Year title. And he won the Super Sport race here way back in 2009. He joins Ducati tomorrow. Look at that crowd, feel that atmosphere. 90,000 people packed into Valencia, packed into the Ricardo Tormo circuit for the final showdown. And who are they supporting? Could you guess?
No idea. Who might it be? Number 93 being proudly displayed by the fans up there. That's just on the entrance to the back straight. Hiroshi Oyama confirmed this morning he'll be riding for Aspar next season alongside Nicky Hayden, back on the Honda. And actually was not having a bad end to the season, really, Hiroshi Oyama, but finished out of the points in the last couple of rounds.
150th Grand Prix start for him, and of course he clinched the 250cc world title here when he finished seventh back in 2009.
Yeah, the kind of ride that Marquez would probably love to have. Michele Pirro, of course, a former winner here at this circuit. Remember that emotional race just a couple of weeks after what happened with Marco Simoncelli at Sepang, and he came here and won the race for the Gresini team in Moto2, and actually took his best CRT finish last year in fifth place.
Colin Edwards looks like he's going to be around next year, which is great news for everybody. I think MotoGP without the Texas Tornado would be a sad old place, wouldn't it?
Yeah, he will be riding with Forward once more on board that FDR Yamaha hybrid bike in the open class. Talk about Randy Depunier, about being a Suzuki test rider. There's also a lot of talk he may well stick around, apparently testing a couple of bikes this week, including Paul Bird's Aprilia.
Yeah, former winner here in the 250cc class, Randy, back in 10 years ago, 2003, he won the 250cc race here in Valencia. Wow.
The stage is set, isn't it?
It is. 5 minutes
to go.
It really is.
before the start of the race. Now there's Carlos Lavado in the background. You just see him with the moustache.
It certainly
did. Former 250cc world champion.
Great character, Venezuelan, of course, and always cheerful. Just going to wish Jorge Lorenzo luck. 5 minutes to go before the start of this 30-lap final showdown to decide the outcome of the 2013 MotoGP World Championship.
Mission impossible is what the circuit commentator has dubbed this one for Jorge Lorenzo. Well, it's certainly mission possible if he goes out there and wins the race, because you never know what's going to happen in MotoGP. As we've seen over the last few weeks, it's been just an incredible turnaround in fortunes, engineered by himself, you have to say, by his own brilliant riding as well. That ride in Japan was one of the best rides you will see from someone leading a race from start to finish, really, ever, because he just the consistency he showed, and he needs more of that today. How quickly will he get away from the line? Will he be ahead of Marc Márquez into turn one? Steely gaze from Márquez up on pole. He says, I'm not a great starter. That's possibly my weakest part of the race, but at least I'm in pole. And so I'm not going to lose out as much as if I were behind. We just got quick confirmation as well, as we said to you briefly before, that all three riders on the front row of the grid are on the harder option front tyre and the harder option rear tyre.
Confirmation of that front row. Danny Pedrosa, the current world champion, Jorge Lorenzo, riding the factory Yamaha. He trails the young pretender to his crown, Marc Márquez, by 13 precious points. Márquez, 6 Grand Prix wins this season. Will he become the youngest ever Premier Class Grand Prix world champion? Welcome back to Valencia. I'm Nick Harris, sitting alongside me Gavin Emmett down in pit lane. Dylan Gray, the moment has arrived.
Of course, it's the championship leader Marc Márquez on pole position. The reigning champ Jorge Lorenzo in second place, with Dani Pedrosa, last year's race winner here at Valencia, in third. All Yamaha row two, with Valentino Rossi, Cal Crutchlow and Bradley Smith. Can they lend their colleague Jorge Lorenzo a favour?
Third row of the grid, Alvaro Bautista, Stefan Bradl and Andrea Dovizioso. The fourth row, Nicky Hayden, Andrea Iannone and Danilo Petrucci.
Row five, Hector Barbera, Aleix Espargaró and Claudio Corti, with Johnny Hernandez alongside Michele Pirro, who crashed in qualifying, and Colin Edwards on the sixth row.
Row seven, Hiroshi Oyama, his 150th Grand Prix, Randy Depriniere and Michael Lafferty. And we have Lucas Kasha, Brian Staring and Damien Cudlin completing the grid. Pešek and, of course, Martin Bayer making just his second Grand Prix appearance.
Slight lull as everyone gets ready for the final warm-up lap before the start of this 30-lap MotoGP event here at the Ricardo Tormo Circuit on the western outskirts of Valencia, the east coast of Spain. The whole country has come to a halt, ready for the next 45 minutes of Grand Prix action. Will Jorge Lorenzo get a start like that when we get to down to the race? We've seen him go off like a scalded rabbit in recent races and take the fight to the rest of the field. It might not be enough to do that here today. Will he just go on and try and win the race and hope something happens behind him? Or will he try and force the hand of Marc Márquez and play a few games with the rookie?
Perfect conditions, massive crowd. You really could not ask for any more. Marc Márquez has to finish fourth or above to clinch the world title and put that final chapter into the record books that he has completely rewritten this season. A certain Jorge Lorenzo plans to prevent that happening.
A few clouds overhead now. You can still see the sun shining through. 104,000 fans in attendance as well. Brilliant. And down in pit lane, Dylan, it's got to be tense, hasn't it?
Oh, it's absolutely great down here. And like you say, just everyone's almost silent now, even the crowd, just expecting in terms of weather, still good. Wind has picked up a little bit now, a little bit cloudy, but I don't think that's going to cause us any problems for the race.
Who will be crowned the new world champion after 30 laps of the circuit? Marc Marquez must be favourite with that 13-point advantage, but the way Jorge Lorenzo is riding and what we've seen in other classes, what we've seen in other races of late, you cannot put your money on everybody. There you go. 13 points between Marquez and Lorenzo, who will be crowned the new world champion.
It's a beautiful afternoon here in Valencia to have the 18th and final round of MotoGP in 2013. It's a goodbye from MotoGP, but let's hope that it's a cracking send-off here at Valencia.
30 laps, round 18 of the championship. Jorge Lorenzo, 7 Grand Prix victories this season. Marc Marquez, 6 Grand Prix victories. Dani Pedrosa, the man that's got the best record here in Valencia. We've waited 14 days for this moment. It has arrived. The final showdown of the 2013 MotoGP World Championship. Lights to red, let battle commence.
A good start from Jorge Lorenzo yet again. He just hooked it up really nicely as the light went out. And look at that, Pedrosa is past Marquez. It looks like Bradley Smith could be past Marquez. Rossi tries to round the outside and Marquez has come back and he's in third place as Lorenzo leads, Pedrosa in second, Marquez in third, but Marquez almost out of shape at the Mick Doohan corner. He brings it back round, thankfully.
He did well, Marc Marquez, one to bring it back and also not to get sucked into a Yamaha battle down at turn one. We expected Lorenzo to lead. We probably thought Pedrosa was going to be second, but Marquez has done a good job because those three Yamaha riders behind him on the second row did not beat him down towards turn one.
Yeah, there were a couple of wide moments though at turn two, then at turn four as well from Marc Marquez. Just wanted to go tires to come up to temperature as quickly as possible. He's got Valentino Rossi breathing down his neck at the moment as we tip into turn eight for the very first time. The track just drops away there, then it's back round. Dani Pedrosa piling the pressure on Lorenzo already in these early stages. Can he find a way through on Lorenzo up towards turn 11? We're on board with Valentino Rossi looking at the champion-elect.
Yeah, now will he try and unsettle Marc Marquez? Can he do that through the switch here? It's right then left, 12, 13, and that vital turn 14 back into the start and finish straight. Lorenzo expected to be here. Can the Yamahas behind Marquez do anything to unsettle the 20-year-old?
I'm not sure they're going to be able to, and I suppose for Marquez it's quite good that he's got Pedrosa just in front of him harassing and harrying Lorenzo, because Lorenzo will know that he needs to win this race. And if Pedrosa puts himself in front, as he has done down into turn one, it was actually Pedrosa leading across the line. Bautista comes through on Valentino Rossi. A great start from Bautista on that softer option tyre. Lorenzo fights it back already into turn two. He forces Pedrosa wide and retakes the lead.
Well, we've seen battles between these two in 125, 250cc races, and they've now transferred into MotoGP. Lorenzo determined to hold the lead. Pedrosa determined to help his teammate Marquez, who can watch very comfortably at the moment from third place.
Slight moment there for Lorenzo in turn four as well, but he managed to bring it round okay. Pedrosa once more tries to fire that Honda. Look how quickly he's trying to get through on the inside into turn seven. Fast left-hand kink on the back straight. They'll tighten up once more, wider line as you'd expect from the Yamaha, and Jorge Lorenzo hangs on to the lead, but it's been a fierce start already and still a long way to go in the race. Marquez just sitting back and watching as a spectator as it is.
Yeah, you got to say, first points have gone in a very long battle to Honda. Beautifully placed at the moment. Alvaro Bautista just about protecting also, of course, on another Honda who's got in front of Valentino Rossi. There's nothing Lorenzo could do. He's just got to go on and win the race. But as we stand at the moment, they look nicely placed.
I'm not sure there's anything he can do with Pedrosa in there protecting Marquez. It's not like if Lorenzo slows down, then Pedrosa will clear off and that won't help him at all. Here comes Pedrosa. Looks to have it hooked up once again beautifully out of the final corner. And he does come through down into turn one. Fires it very hard in there. He's surely going to run it a bit wide. And Lorenzo does come through once more. So hard into turn one for Pedrosa and left the door wide open on exit.
This is Lorenzo back in front up at the Mick Doohan corner. Down towards three and four they come. Then to, four and five they come. Pedrosa thinks about getting up the inside once again. Up towards the Angel Nieto corner. Turn six at this Ricardo Tormo circuit. We've already seen the lead swap three times.
Stefan Bradl, the fastest rider on that lap. It's a new circuit record for Bradl, but that surely will go once one rider settles down in front and starts to impose a pace on this race. But Lorenzo's not being allowed to settle by Pedrosa, and Marc Márquez will be already wanting to shake Dani Pedrosa's hand because he's helping him out no end here.
Yeah, he's doing a brilliant job, Dani Pedrosa. You were so right, because Lorenzo wants to start slowing the pace. He knows that Pedrosa is so capable of going by and absolutely clearing off. So he's got to keep the pace quick at the moment. What his tactics will be after that, I don't know.
Well, I suppose if he keeps the pace at this level, you've got eight riders in that front group, but even more all the way down to Nicky Hayden, really. But it looks all the way down to Bradl. They are still involved in this one in some way. So maybe it is a tactic. Maybe not go off like a shot like he has done at recent rounds of the championship. He has no option, really. Yes, he has to win the race, but he's got to force Márquez into a mistake in some way. 32.2 from Lorenzo. He was running consistent low 131s on that tyre yesterday, but maybe just taking a little bit more time to come up to temperature to get comfortable with it, with the condition. Just a slight touchdown on yesterday.
Yeah, Pedrosa not getting past Lorenzo that time at turn one. You saw his rear wheel right off the ground as he brakes so hard. This is as aggressive as we've seen from Dani Pedrosa this season.
And Lorenzo's going to try and fight back into turn five. Oh, they're going to almost touch as they come through there. Pedrosa forced wide once more by Lorenzo. He just doesn't want to allow the Honda a moment. And again, Márquez was so close into the back of Pedrosa there, almost forced to sit up. But he trusted his teammate and brought it back round in third place.
We wanted a showdown. By golly, have we got a showdown. This is amazing stuff. We ride with Dani Pedrosa. We now ride with Jorge Lorenzo. Márquez is comfortably there in third place, but he's got Batista right behind him, and he almost ran into the back there of Dani Pedrosa.
Through turn 11 now for Jorge Lorenzo. Is this his tactic? Has this been it to make sure? Look, Bautista's there. You got Rossi there. Bradley Smith is behind Rossi, ahead of his teammate Crutchlow again, who's laboured at the start, but you know he's going to come good as well. So if you can keep this group going, it's only going to help Jorge Lorenzo. Down into the final corner. This is where Lorenzo's been strong all year, and again, runs it wide coming out of that final corner, almost inviting the Hondas through.
And through they've come, one would imagine. Dani Pedrosa almost side by side down into turn one. Oh, Lorenzo leaves his braking very, very late indeed and holds the advantage.
This is an epic start to the race from Lorenzo and Pedrosa. And Márquez has got the best seat in the house as things stand. And for him, it's quite comfortable. A little bit wide for Lorenzo through turn two on exit. Into three, though, he reclaims the advantage.
Fabulous start to the race. We wondered how it would be, how this showdown would come out. Well, nothing would surprise me now what would happen in this race.
I almost guarantee that Lorenzo is running a much slower pace than he would like. He's just taking a little bit off in every corner. He's a second or more behind where he ran comfortably yesterday. And it's playing. It's trying to keep the group together while staying in front. It's not the easiest track to overtake on and stay in front, as we know, because so often if you do get in front, you're running it wide on the next corner. And again, it's all about Lorenzo trying to hold this race up. We know he can go quicker than this.
And he is holding up, and he's doing a good job. And when Dani Pedrosa's got past him, he's got past him immediately, got back at him straight away. Because Rossi and Batista are right in this group. It's a group of five at the front.
Of course, if Lorenzo were in this position and Márquez at the back of this group, he would be world champion. So he is riding exactly as he would like as things stand.
Onto the front straight they come once again. When they cross the line, there will be 25 laps to go, a long, long way. The championship decider, and it's still Lorenzo that leads the way down into turn one. Pedrosa, Márquez, seen nothing of him so far, riding a steady third place. Batista right behind him, and Valentino Rossi at the back of that group. And still Bradley Smith holding off his teammate, Cal Crutchlow.
Again, Lorenzo just leaving the door slightly ajar, almost inviting Pedrosa to come in. But what it's doing as well is it's meaning that Márquez thinks he can get through on Pedrosa. And again, Pedrosa lunges from afar. Lorenzo saw it coming and just pulled the bike back in front of him. How many times have we seen the lead change in these first five laps?
This is an absolutely brilliant ride by Lorenzo. He's trying all he can to slow the pace. He's inviting people on, and then he's retaking them again. Absolutely superb ride. Totally different from the ride we saw from him in Motegi. But again, it's the ride of a world champion. He ain't going to give this one up, you know.
through the chicane up towards turn 11. I think this time it's going to be line astern as they come into that corner and on the exit once more. This was up at turn 2. Again, look how close Marquez got as Pedrosa closed in on the back of Lorenzo. This is a game he's wanting to play. And Marquez still knows he has to ride hard to stay in that position ahead of Bautista, ahead of Rossi, both world champions, of course.
Just unsettle him. Just slow the pace, up the pace. Just make him not ride a nice, fast, smooth, aggressive pace that he wants to ride. That's what Lorenzo is doing all the time.
I suppose he's also inviting Marquez to have a go at Pedrosa and come through and go on, have a go with me and I'll take you on. Pedrosa's just sitting back on this lap. He realises what the game is. Another 32.5 from Lorenzo, taking different lines in every single corner, playing with the riders behind him. Some dark clouds ominously loom over the back of the circuit. We're now on board with Dani Pedrosa, looking back at the number 93 Repsol Honda of his teammate, Marc Márquez. Elbow down as he comes through turn 5, up towards the Angel Nieto corner, the bank left-hander that brings them onto the back straight.
I'm sure Marc Márquez knew exactly how the race would be. He knew Lorenzo would ride the race like this. He knew that he would just...
And Pedrosa's through. Pedrosa is through once more on Lorenzo. This time it's into turn 8, and he's actually done it at a place where it's not easy for Lorenzo to get straight back now. What can Lorenzo respond with? Here he comes! He almost takes Dani Pedrosa's right leg off as he comes through turn 11. Oh, Pedrosa wasn't expecting that at all. He fights straight back. This is incredible stuff from Lorenzo. And Dani Pedrosa doesn't quite know what to do there.
Just superb stuff from Lorenzo. As I said, that race in Motegi I thought was his greatest. This is unbelievable. They're at it once again.
Oh, and on the inside, he's going to force Pedrosa a little bit wide, but he's not having the battle with Pedrosa. With Marquez, who's behind the shake of the head from Pedrosa, then he's got to understand that Lorenzo is riding for the title here.
Down into turn 1, 23 laps ago. If it continues like this, 1, we will be hoarse. 2, this crowd are going to be going absolutely crazy. They are already.
Again, in the middle of the corner, both those Honda bikes close up on Jorge Lorenzo. He's playing the game to perfection, but Valentino Rossi is losing touch on the back of Bautista. It'll be interesting to see what the pit board tells him in terms of the group of riders that he has behind him, that Rossi is losing touch. And in fact, behind Rossi, it's a second back to Cal Crutchlow, who has finally been able to make it through his teammate, Bradley Smith.
It's a mistake now from Marquez that will hand the title to Lorenzo. I think you're right. I think it's... Bautista's not going to do anything silly, is he? He's a Honda rider. And Lorenzo will just have to try and rough it up even more. I've never seen him ride so aggressively. I don't think I've seen Dani Pedrosa ride so aggressively as well.
Take a deep breath there, Danny, as Lorenzo almost took off the side panel of that Honda for the second time in three corners. This time it's comfortable enough through turns 12 and 13. They know they can run a faster pace, 32.7. They know that Lorenzo is trying to play with them. Marc Márquez can just use his teammates as a kind of buffer between himself and the reigning champ. Third place is good enough. I'm sure he wants to go out with a win, but he wouldn't care either way if he was putting his plaque on board that champion's trophy. Now Lorenzo stretches it out on this lap, a 132.0, his fastest lap of the race and the overall fastest lap of the race, a new race lap record.
Yeah, is he going to change his tactics a little bit now? Is he going to really up the pace? Let's see if he can run with me at my proper race pace that I was showing her yesterday. Tactical, this absolutely superb stuff from Lorenzo. Pedrosa and Lorenzo, it's more like they're 250cc, 125cc days, and Marquez quite happy to sit in there at the moment in third place. He's not made a mistake yet.
Tense moments there for Julian Marquez, Mark's father. And you can blame him for having both fingers crossed as well. He'll have everything else crossed that he can, just hoping that Mark doesn't come a cropper in some way.
We ride with Jorge Lorenzo right in his face, number 26, Dani Pedrosa, back with Pedrosa. That's Lorenzo in front of him. Marquez just nicely, convenient back just a little bit, isn't he? Very perfectly placed. Bautista, you know, he's not going to make any sort of move. It's down to Rossi, but Rossi is having to work very, very hard to keep this group in sight, isn't he?
He's there. He's still there on the back of Bautista. He's still trying to get involved in some way. Again, Pedrosa gets extremely close to the rear of Jorge Lorenzo as they come through that final corner. And you can just see, right, Marquez P3 and a group of four, he's being told. So does that mean close things up a little bit, Jorge? As Dani Pedrosa again down towards turn one. This is aggressive. And look at Marquez right in behind Lorenzo this time.
Up they come up towards the mid-turn curve. Lorenzo fights back. There's no way through that time. There he is. He's pushed Dani Pedrosa wide.
He's pushed him right off the track as well. He had to do it, and now Marquez takes over at the front. Can Marquez try and push away? This is perhaps what Lorenzo wanted, a straight hand-to-hand combat between himself and the rookie. Dani Pedrosa won't be happy about that one bit. I just saw a puff of smoke in the background. I don't know whether it was Dani Pedrosa. That was it into turn two. They touched there. He touched the second time. And Pedrosa tries to get back into the race, but he's down there in fifth spot now. And Cal Crutchlow it was who went down at the back of that group.
Oh, what a sad end to his career with the Tech 3 Yamaha team for Cal Crutchlow. Right, what can Marquez do at the front? Can he up the pace so much? And he disappears and wins the World Championship. This is suddenly the whole feature of the race, the whole way of the race has changed, yeah, hasn't it?
The dynamic has certainly altered now, because it's Marquez leading from Lorenzo. It's been about Lorenzo and Pedrosa in the first third of this race, but there's still a long way to go, and already Jorge Lorenzo now is tracking the pretender to his crown, the man who wants to wrest it off the top of his head. And they come into the start-finish straight. It'll be 10 down and 20 laps still to come.
Remember their race in Sepang for five or six laps? They scrapped it out like a couple of school kids, didn't they? And Lorenzo and Marquez, very aggressive. I tell you, Lorenzo is riding as aggressively as I've ever seen him ride. He has to. He will try and rough up Marc Marquez now at the front, and here he comes.
Into turn two, this time again, he's very strong in there once more, and he takes the lead from Marquez. He's going to have to try and slow things up. He's got to play with the rookie.
He is playing with him. He's putting him through a thorough examination at the moment. At the moment, he's coming through with flying colours, Marc Marquez. But what else has Lorenzo got up his sleeve? Because we've seen everything from him so far.
Into Angel Nieto corner again. They come extremely close to each other. Will Marc Marquez be content to just sit in there behind Jorge Lorenzo? Or will he just think, right, you know what, I'm going to do this the proper way. I'm going to win the championship by winning the race. And he comes through aggressively on Lorenzo. And actually, the door's been open there almost for Bautista to come through. But Cal Bautista's almost rolled off to allow Marquez to keep that second spot.
Yeah, and he keeps rolling off. He's going to get taken, isn't he, by Valentino Rossi at some stage. Of course, Dani Pedrosa closing back up to make it a five-way battle for the lead. Lorenzo is trying every trick in the book. A double 250cc world champion, a double MotoGP world champion. He knows every trick in the book, and he is giving absolutely everything to Marc Marquez. And at the moment, Marquez is matching him blow for blow.
Again, that warrior spirit we've seen from Jorge Lorenzo over the last few rounds in full evidence here at Valencia, as Rossi comes through on the inside, up into third place for Valentino Rossi. Remember, he lost the World Championship here in 2006 when he came in as the leader. Dani Pedrosa now coming through and up into turn four. Jorge Lorenzo, his overtake is being examined now by the stewards, by race direction. Will be investigated after the race, so he won't even know whatever happened, what they're going to do about it. It was a little bit naughty. As we said, they'll be hauled up in front of race direction.
I just dare not think if he won the world title, what that meeting would be like. Let's see what happens in the race first, and then see what happens after that.
It could be completely immaterial, that if Marquez finishes in the top four, of course, really. And Marquez is there in second place, hounding Jorge Lorenzo now. And Lorenzo needs to do something drastic. Look at the gap opening up to Valentino Rossi back there in that third spot. Very soon, it's going to be Pedrosa back up into third.
This is the incident. It's up at the Doohan corner.
He is on the inside, but yeah, you can see that he has just eased Pedrosa wide and out of the way, and we'll get a rap on the knuckles for that, if nothing else. So we'll see what race direction decide on that one.
Well, they've made some big decisions this year. That could be the biggest decision they ever have to make.
But it certainly looked to me like Pedrosa's in the corner in front of him. Yes, they were alongside, but Pedrosa late on the brakes, and Lorenzo still tried to just stick it in there. almost identical fastest laps of the race from Lorenzo and Marquez. Lorenzo's going the other route now. How hard can I push? How hard can you push, Mark? Trying to drag him into your duel.
It's superb tactics from Lorenzo. Up at the pace. Now, come on, Marquez, let's see what you can run. Let's see what you can do. Danny Pedrosa could certainly get back into it because the pace will drop if he can't drop Mark Marquez or he can't make Marquez make a mistake, and then they could all come back into the mix once again, which of course will suit Lorenzo at the front.
On board here with Valentino Rossi on that gyroscopic defect camera, watching Danny Pedrosa in behind. Got the sparks flying from the toe sliders on Rossi's boots. And some of the riders saying this weekend, it's like, keep thinking fireworks are going off in front of you. Keep thinking there's a crash happening. But as things stand, Rossi is just dropping back 0.8 now down on Marc Marquez.
That's really bad news for Jorge Lorenzo.
Well, again, it's because he is pulling away from Marquez, so maybe it's a case of, right, do you want to run with me? Right, you don't? OK, we'll slow down. We'll bring the others back into it, because Marquez could just sit there now and watch Lorenzo and enjoy watching Lorenzo around this track. Watch the different styles, really. Normally there, Lorenzo is a little bit out of line. We've seen Marquez crossed up through Turn 13 all weekend. Just see that rear wheel spinning up as he comes through that fast left-hander, fourth gear through there. This is on board the Repsol under pit wall as Pedrosa comes through now on Valentino Rossi. He can sense a victory.
Yeah, certainly can. He'd be furious with Jorge Lorenzo, but he's got comfortably through on Valentino Rossi, the race winner here last year. Marquez, I would imagine, would prefer the pace to be up like this. This is how he wants to ride the bike, rather than the slower pace, rather than the problems that may come with a bit of traffic, but comfortably through. He's ridden a great race at Danny Pedrosa, very, very aggressive. And we see what the result of Race Directions inquiry will be after this race is finished, following the touch between him and Jorge Lorenzo.
Yeah, and of course, we don't want this championship decided up in the boardroom at all. It could well, as we say, be completely immaterial if Marquez finishes in the top four. But Lorenzo seems to have settled into a bit of a rhythm now, as he was during practice. If things ended like this, then Lorenzo would only be 8 points behind, but it wouldn't matter. Marquez would be the world champion, the youngest ever world champion in the history of the sport.
We ride with Marc Marquez now back to live coverage of this final round of the MotoGP World Championship. We've been looking so forward to this race, but those opening 10, even 15 laps are as good as you could ever see for a championship showdown. I still think there's more to come.
Not 15 just yet, they're just about to complete lap 14 now. Still quite a long way to go, we're not even at halfway point in the race. A new fastest lap, a 131.7, he's back in that groove, isn't he? Oh, Marquez just a little bit out of shape. He always has looked on the ragged edge a bit this weekend, but manages eventually to get the bike stopped and turned.
He's definitely changed the tactics, hasn't he now, Lorenzo? He's gone from the slowing, let's get everybody involved in the party to see, right, let's see if you can run at my sort of pace. Of course, Marquez doesn't need to be getting sucked into this, especially with Danny Pedrosa behind him, but knowing Marquez, he could well get sucked into the plot.
Up towards Angel Nieto corner for Lorenzo and then Marquez, first and second. Both gone this with the same tyre options, no difference like there was in Japan, of course, just a couple of weeks ago when Lorenzo took a bit of a gamble on the super soft tyre that Bridgestone had brought there. It's actually a brand new tyre that they're going with now. They've only used it in testing previously at the San Marino round of the championship. They haven't been able to use the hard tyre much all season. And finally, Bridgestone have come up with something the riders have consensually liked, and so it's being run this weekend, and the majority of riders have gone with it.
He's on the charge, isn't he? He's opening up that gap at the front all the time. Marquez will be quite happy sitting in there. So he stands, especially he's got his teammate Danny Pedrosa behind him, but it really doesn't look like there's going to be a threat from Valentino Rossi. Will Lorenzo try and slow the pace towards the end of the race? Will he try and change the tactics? He's in a very difficult situation now, isn't he?
Yeah, he really is, because, again, the gap back behind Marquez is opening up all the time. It could well be, like he's been told there's a group of four. Yeah, he's been told to slow down a little bit. Gap opening up, being told to hold things up. Maybe in his head he's just thinking, you know what, I'm clearly not going to be able to slow it down to get enough riders in in between us. I'm just going to go on and win this race. Going to go on and do it and go out with a blaze of glory.
I think there will be a point in the race. I don't think he's probably reached it yet. That's exactly how he's going to feel, don't you? And say, well, right, I'm going to make it three in a row. I'm going to go out and win eight Grand Prix and lose the championship perhaps by 8 points. There's nothing I can do about that.
Think of himself as a moral victor in one way by having won more races.
Yeah.
You just see on those last three laps, Lorenzo taking one or two tenths on every single lap out of Marquez, who's comfortable there in second place. His teammate behind him is not going to do anything too risky. This is down at turn one. You can just see it bouncing around for Marquez, but he rides like that. That's comfortable enough for him.
Yeah, for others, you may say, that's a little bit of a twitch, a bit of a problem. That's the way Marc Marquez rides a motorcycle. That's when he's at his happiest, when he can ride it like that.
Been watching him through turn 13 this weekend has been immense. The way he's had that bike crossed up, fourth gear corner that they're coming through at turn 14, about 200 kilometers an hour as they fire it through that corner. And just incredible to see him go over the crest. And just having a look at the lap times that go around, 131.9 from Lorenzo, so just dropping back a couple. But Marquez has the luxury to match that and drop back even further. You see how far Rossi is behind, and Bautista as well. Those fireworks of the early laps are a distant memory as things stand as far as Jorge Lorenzo and his title aspirations are concerned.
Well, he's tried two big tactics. He's tried to slow up, he's roughed it up. He's been ridden very, very aggressively. Now he's decided to go out at the front. He's probably got one more throw of the dice. You've got to think that one more throw of the dice is to try and invite Marc Marquez to get involved in a little bit of a scrap. But as we stand at the moment, Marquez has one hand on the trophy.
Dani Pedrosa's pace is very similar to that of Marquez in front, keeping his distance. He'll want to repay the favour, I'm sure, to Jorge Lorenzo. I wouldn't like to be between them in Parc Fermé, but I'm sure in one way Pedrosa will understand what's at stake here for Jorge Lorenzo. He has a little look around as he comes round at turn 11, seeing if there's any way he can entice Marquez into a bit of hand-to-hand combat.
Poor old Dani Pedrosa, it always happens to him. Yeah. He doesn't invite it. It happened in Aragon, it's happened here again. It'll be interesting to see race direction, I suppose. So they look at Aragon, they look at here, and there was no points taken away, nothing as far as championships go, was it?
Yeah, I just wonder, it might be 3 points on his license.
Yeah, that's probably exactly what it would be.
The greatest of starts from Marquez. Look at him, he was back almost in fifth at one point, but came through very bravely on the inside of Rossi. And Rossi then forced to sit up with Marquez on his interior.
It was a very good first bend in the end from Marquez, because he was in danger of getting swallowed up a little bit by the Yamahas, and he fought back and didn't let that happen.
Just further down the order, just to clear up a bit of housekeeping, really. Bautista back in fifth, and then there's a 5 second gap back to Bradle, another 4 seconds back to Bradley Smith, who's 2.5 seconds ahead of Nicky Hayden in eighth place, having a decent ride on his last one for Ducati with Iannone, and then Dovizioso making up the top 10. Top CRT is Aleix Espargaró in 11th place.
This is the start from Jorge Lorenzo. Great start it was. Dani Pedrosa right behind him. You'll just get a glimpse there of Marquez coming up the inside of Valentino Rossi as they go through turn one, up towards turn two. Right, what's going through his head now? He's a thinking man's motorcycle racer. He's a superb world champion. And I tell you what, he will try one. He's got one more trick, I'm sure he has. And surely that's got to be to really slow the pace.
Yeah, you've got to think what is up his sleeve. Has he got anything there? A rabbit to pull out of the hat still.
There will be a point, as you said, in the race with a few laps to go here, I think, right.
Oh, will there?
Will
he dangle the carrot of a race victory to win his championship in front of Marquez?
I'm sure he will. I'm absolutely certain he's going to do that. Will Marquez come and have a bite of the carrot, or do he say, I'm not going to fall for that one?
Alvaro Bautista having a decent ride in fifth place. Maybe he went with a softer option tyre, so maybe in the latter stages we'll just not be able to keep tabs on Valentino Rossi. Bradley Smith in seventh place. Of course, his teammate Cal Crutchlow crashed out in his last ride for Tech 3 Yamaha. Nicky Hayden in his last ride for Ducati as well, having a decent one, 10 seconds ahead of Iannone and Dovizioso. It looked to me like Dovizioso at turn two on that first lap was forced a bit wide.
Good battle between the two Italians.
Dovizioso's mojo seems to have gone a little bit over the second half of the season. His best results were fifth place, was at Mugello, and since then has not even scaled the top six.
You know, only a real injury hit season on his debut, as it is the debut, of course, for Marc Márquez in MotoGP. Are they just snipping those boxes of T-shirts in the Repsol Honda garage? Are they just checking that they're there with that World Championship a T-shirt ready? Or are they keeping them at the back of the box still? Or is somebody starting just to check them out?
Dani Pedrosa is closing lap on lap on Marc Márquez now. He's probably thinking, look, if I get through, it doesn't really affect Marc's championship at all. He won't want to make a mistake if he is going to pass. It's still 11 laps to go in the race. He's 2 seconds down on Lorenzo. His pace is, no, but identical to Lorenzo.
11 to go. Through turn one they come. Are we looking at the 2013 MotoGP World Champion in action? Can he hang on to second place? Can he take the lead if Jorge Lorenzo drops the pace? What is his teammate Dani Pedrosa going to do? It does look a very, very good position indeed for the Honda team. But we probably said that at Phillip Island at some stage, didn't we?
Yeah, who'd have thought this would be where it would end for Marc Márquez, of course, after he battled to an opening podium in Qatar with Valentino Rossi, with Lorenzo going on to take the victory. He then bounced back brilliantly, didn't he, after a crash in the in a practice at Austin in the Grand Prix of the Americas to win in just his second ride in the Premier Class.
There's Valentino Rossi in fourth place. It does appear there's very little he can do to help his teammate Jorge Lorenzo. We've seen him there so many times this season. Alvaro Bautista as well in fifth place. We've seen those two battle it out. Usually Cal Crutchlow's in that trio as well, making it a trio. But of course, he has crashed out of the race.
This was a start again on board with Valentino Rossi. Look how quickly Lorenzo was past Márquez there. And Rossi was also past Márquez. He's just on the inside, is the championship leader. You'll just see his front wheel come through any moment now. There it is, back in front of Rossi. He had to allow him the room on the inside. Came Márquez a little bit out of shape. But already, even on that first lap, Lorenzo was taking different lines to the Honda riders. Lorenzo's pace is very consistent now, 31.7s, 31.8, lap after lap. Márquez on the last two has set personal best laps, but he's just maintaining that 1.5 second gap to Lorenzo. Pedrosa, meanwhile, just a tenth down on that one, on the duo in front of him.
He's not been sucked into any sort of fight, is he, Marc Márquez? He knows exactly where he is. He knows exactly what the situation is. And if it remains the same, he will be the youngest ever world champion in the premier class of Grand Prix motorcycle racing. So this is a very, very big 9.5 laps for a 20-year-old Spaniard that's come in and blown this championship absolutely wide open. He's blown it apart.
A few more explosions at the end of the race as well. This is Firework Mad Valencia. And whoever wins, they'll be setting off fireworks well into the early hours. You'll be able to hear yourself think straight after the race. Deafening noise as well as they celebrate to whoever is going to be their world champion this year. As they come through across this time, there'll be 9 laps to go in this race. 9 laps between Marc Márquez and his world championship in his rookie year, a new fastest lap of the race from Jorge Lorenzo, a 131.7, as he just thought, to hell with it. I want to take my 8th win of the year, go out on a high, end the season with 3 victories and show that we have what it takes to put the fight up to Honda.
I think you're exactly right. I think he's worked out the situation. I mean, he can't know everything that's going on behind him, but the board has told him really that they wanted him to try and slow it up. Let's go for it. Let's go and show everybody why I am such a worthy world champion. I am still a world champion until Marc Márquez crosses the line. And there's nothing else I can do but win the race and just show that next year I'm going to be back big star. I'm already excited about next year, aren't you? We're going to have some more races like this.
Intriguingly as well, there's also a Constructors' Championship up for grabs here today. 13 points separate Honda and Yamaha. Again in that one, but of course if things stayed the same, then Honda would be crowned Constructors' Champions. Repsol Honda team are already already confirmed as Team World Champions.
Well, are we watching Jorge Lorenzo's last 8.5 laps as a MotoGP World Champion? If we are, he is putting on a super show.
Yeah, he's made the race today, definitely. Not sure Dani Pedrosa would quite agree, but he certainly has kept it lively, kept it interesting for us. Maybe there's an ace up his sleeve somewhere, but I can't see him drawing markers into anything now. 1.7 the gap between them. Dani Pedrosa, a new fastest lap of the race, a 131.6. Maybe he will be the thorn in Marquez's side, but I really doubt he's going to put anything too aggressive on his teammate.
No, he's getting no help, Jorge Lorenzo. That's the problem. Valentino Rossi can't match there. Cal Crutchlow's gone. Bradley Smith, you wouldn't expect to match him. He's doing a good job in seventh place. And consequently, the Hondas can really run the race now how they want to run it. Although, people make mistakes in these situations. Moto2, the race that's just gone by without giving anything away. Big mistake by somebody who had a big lead in the race. So it can happen, but Marquez, I'm sure, is in the zone.
Just as well to clear up a few things, Lukas Peszek crashed out early on, as did Damian Cudlin, the Aussie on board the Paul Bird bike. Johnny Hernandez, another one of those who to have retired from the race. He came into the pits with a problem on board that Pramac Ducati. Wonder if he'll be riding that bike next year. We still have no confirmation on who will be where at Pramac. Cal Crutchlow back in the team garage now. And, of course, disappointment for him after crashing out at turn four.
Just a note on Pramac, Iannone has been confirmed on the on a factory bike, and Hernandez will be on the current year's bike, but with the Dorna electronics and 24 litres.
So the spec software for him. Yeah, it looked like that might happen. So they've finally confirmed it. That's good to see.
What must be going through Marc Marquez's head? He's 20 years old. He knows about winning world titles. He won the 125cc title here 3 years ago when he finished fourth in the race. He's a Moto2 world champion. This is Dani Pedrosa. He also knows about winning world titles. Well, won 125 and a couple of 250s. Lorenzo just keeps ploughing on, but Marquez now must be fully concentrated on the job in hand and not thinking about a world title, not thinking about where they're going to have their first drink tonight, not thinking about the party, not thinking about the celebrations, just concentrate on the road ahead.
I just hope we get another little dance like we got from him when he won the championship in Moto2 back in Australia. It was quite entertaining. Certainly knows how to enjoy himself. He was enjoying himself, actually, after the Japanese Grand Prix a couple of weeks ago, letting his hair down before this title showdown. Very relaxed rider, knows how to have fun off the bike as much as he does clearly on it.
Oh, what a great life, eh? You can ride a motorcycle like this. Life must be absolutely fantastic. Turn 11. So that's, what, 7.25 laps to go. You can see Jorge Lorenzo in front of him. He won't give a monkey's. He knows that he's safe and sound exactly where he is. No mistakes. Fully concentrate. Over the rise. Down towards turn 14.
Listen to that hitting. 15,000 revs almost coming through at that corner at nearly 200 kilometres an hour as well. And then powering it down that home straight. Once more, six laps remaining.
Randy Depunier's also had to pull into the pits with what looks like a mechanical problem.
Oh, the end of a miserable season for Randy Depunier. But now all eyes, all of Spain, focus on number 93, the 20-year-old Spaniard, Marc Marquez.
Still crossing it up, coming through turn 13. As Lorenzo winds his way towards an eighth Grand Prix victory of the season. Santi Hernandez, Emilio Altamura on the pit wall for Repsol Honda there. Won't care a jot about Lorenzo winning the race. If Marquez can come home in second or even third place, seeing as Dani Pedrosa's closing in all the time on Marquez.
I'm sure he's going to be mighty, mighty careful about any overtaking manoeuvres here, Dani Pedrosa. 2006, yeah. Dani Pedrosa and Nicky Hayden,
penultimate race,
penultimate round.
If Marquez were passed and finished third, it'd be his, apart from disqualification in Australia, it'd be his worst finish to a race since Barcelona, because all the others have been first or second.
He's a worthy world champion, but of course he is, the points tell you that. Jorge Lorenzo is a worthy world champion. Boy, has he defended that crown. And the battle next year should be extraordinary, as it has been this year. It's not over yet.
Oh, look at Pedrosa, change from front to rear as he comes through at turn 13 there, stepping out the front as he just rolled off a little bit of the traction control, shifting the bike's weight a touch. And he is closing. It's now down to 0.3 of a second between himself and Marquez.
Five laps to go between Marc Marquez and that 2013 MotoGP world title, the youngest ever world champion in the class he would be in the 65-year history of Grand Prix racing, and the first rookie to take the championship since Kenny Roberts way, way back in 1978.
I'm sure Kenny's watching on back in California. I'm not sure he'll mind too much about that record going. He may well, knowing Kenny, if we said that to him, he'd say, of course I mind.
Yeah. Danny Pedrosa up into second place. Don't do that, Danny Pedrosa. Don't mind you going through, but you don't want to have any moments right in front of the potential world champion.
Oh, dear me.
Oh, dear, oh, dear.
Again,
but Marquez rides so close to him. Why did he open a little bit of a gap?
Yeah, Pedrosa there getting into a bit of a tank slapper coming out of turn six. And just hope he didn't upset the brake pads or anything like that. But it seems to be okay for him. And we saw that with Aleix Espargaró, didn't we, in Japan, who had a moment on the back straight and had to bail off the bike, basically, because there was no brake power.
Into the start and finish straight they come. There will be four laps to go. Marc Marquez in a very safe, secure third place. He's got his teammate Danny Pedrosa in front of him, Jorge Lorenzo. Let's have a look at this a moment again. This is the overtake. He's signalling him through, isn't he? He's telling him, yeah, that's the gap for you. It's just after here.
And just he got on the power. Marc, just allowing it through. Santinande's just saying, comfortably enough with that. Again, I think tactic may well have been that from Marquez. Use Danny as a buffer, use Pedrosa as a kind of
front-end gunner. That's right, yeah. Just guide you through.
Pedrosa can sit after Lorenzo, but 3.2 seconds the gap. Lorenzo now cruising towards that win. He has obviously just said, right, I'm going to take my win. And glory associated with that. Of course, if things ended like this, 4 points would be the gap between himself and Marquez.
Couldn't be closer. Marc Marquez really on track now to rewrite the history books. He smashed every record you could imagine. We've got pages of stats here from Dr. Martin Raines that we're not going to read out until the race is over, but he's very, very close to it now. Well done, Jorge Lorenzo, putting on another great display at the front.
Andrea Iannone goes down, looks like it could be turn one for the Italian.
Turn one. You just think, have they left any gravel out there? Has he dropped anything off the bike? Do they know when they come through that there may be a problem there? Yellow flag still being waved as Lorenzo arrives.
He seems to be through comfortably enough. But yeah, you do worry, don't you, about there being a possibility. Of course, Marc Marquez has come a cropper with yellow flags waving early on this year at Silverstone when he crashed behind Cal Crutchlow in morning warm-up, giving himself a couple of penalty points to his racing licence.
Well, Jorge Lorenzo, enjoy watching a world champion in action. He is a very special world champion, and he will be back of that. There is no doubt if he does lose the current title battle to Marc Marquez.
Nothing they can do back there at Yamaha. Just applaud what an excellent season Lorenzo has put in. Barring injury, you know, it would have been a different story. I'm not saying he necessarily would have won it even if he was fully fit, because again, Marquez would have had to ride differently at certain parts of the championship. But he's put on a fantastic show, and another one here today. Danny Pedrosa up into second place. I just wonder what will happen in the stewards room after the race, up at race direction. Will they say to Lorenzo, you've got to drop a spot? Could this win eventually go to Pedrosa? It won't matter if Marquez can bring that home comfortably in third position. He's got to keep going, though, hasn't he, Jorge Lorenzo?
Of course he has, and keep the pace going as well, just in case.
Keep it up, because you never know. We've seen earlier in Moto3 people just lose that little bit of concentration.
But there's no better rider, is there, in the World Championship at the front than Lorenzo. He rides on rails when he's in this sort of mood. Marquez, two laps to go. He's getting mighty, mighty close. They are opening the box
now. He'll be feeling every single bump out there.
Every sound.
Everything that he can hear coming from his bike. Is everything okay?
Look at Dad.
He'll be on his nerve's edge riding around on this penultimate lap.
I'm nervous for him, to be honest with you. So what he must be like, what his family must feel like. But don't hide from it. He has blown this World Championship absolutely wide open. He's the biggest thing to appear in MotoGP. Well, we say since Valentino Rossi. Valentino Rossi didn't win in his rookie year. He has been absolutely phenomenal.
It's been an immense season that he's put together here in MotoGP. Just bring it round now, Mark. I think he deserves this one here. So he comes through on a back marker now, through on Brian Staring and Lucas Gasser as well. We can just see them go past, and as well Michael Laverty involved in that battle too. That's down there for 17th, 18th, 19th. And actually, Skasser, to be fair, Laverty had sat up to allow the leaders through. Skasser had gone through and he's actually let Laverty back in front of him.
Jorge Lorenzo starts the last lap as the MotoGP World Champion. Enjoy this one, Jorge, because number 93 now has 4 kilometres, 2.5 miles left, and he clinched the title.
Got a 4-second gap back to Valentino Rossi as well, so he can really manage it now on this last lap. Here he is, the number 93 flags wave proudly in the grandstands here as Marquez is on his final tour of duty coming round. It's been the call of duty helmet for Jorge Lorenzo this weekend, and he has listened to the call of duty. He stepped up to the plate here this weekend, Lorenzo. Tried to do anything he could in those early laps. Realised he wasn't going to drag anyone into any kind of shenanigans, and he's going to go on and win this race. We'll find out what happens later on when we get into the stewards' room, but Marc Márquez now can cruise his way to a rookie world championship.
They're not celebrating yet. They're
still.
Emilio Elsamore already in tears, former 125cc world champion, the absolute mentor of Marc Márquez. They're counting down the seconds.
Well, he's brought him through
from his days in
the Spanish championship up into into 125, as it was, up into Moto 2. He's won both those championships, and then, of course, he's going to win his debut season in MotoGP to become the first rookie since Kenny Roberts in 1978, the youngest ever MotoGP world champion. But hats off, first of all, to Jorge Lorenzo.
Jorge Lorenzo wins his 8th Grand Prix of the season, a worthy, worthy world champion. But now we await for the arrival of Marc Márquez.
The new world champion in MotoGP in 2013 is the rookie Marc Márquez. He's done it. He's done it. 20 years old, 266 days, the youngest ever winner in the Premier class, the first rookie to do so since 78. Epic season, epic performance. All credit goes to the new champ. Look at the delight down there at Repsol Honda for Santi Hernandez, Emilio Alfamora. You can see Nakamoto, Livio Supo. They backed the winning horse this year.
The shake of the hands there between Alvaro Bautista and Jorge Lorenzo. Celebration time. Congratulations, Marc Márquez. A worthy world champion. A worthy new name. And here we are. Jorge Lorenzo pulls up alongside him. And I'm sure there's going to be a shake of the hand.
There is great sportsmanship there from the outgoing world champion to the new kid on the block, Marc Márquez. Jubilation down at Repsol Honda. Jubilation in the grandstands as well. The marshals all there to enjoy. Got his mascot is out there on track as well.
3 weeks ago, that Honda pit was in disarray, wasn't it? But they've done it. They've brought the title back. They've done it with Marc Márquez. They've won the constructors' title as well. And now the fireworks will be lit and the celebrations will start in the only way they know here in Valencia.
Well done to Santi Hernandez. He's seen the meteoric rise of Márquez through the ranks of 125, Moto2 and MotoGP. And by coming home in third place here at home in Valencia, he is crowned the world champion. Savour this moment. Savour it, everyone back at home as well, because you're going to be hearing a lot more of that name But don't forget what Lorenzo has had to do this season to keep it going right down to the wire. He's taken victory here again. Let's not forget.
Well, and Yamaha, they stepped it up when they had to as well. They brought that seamless transmission gearbox when they were taking on Honda, and they've won the last three races, and it's been an amazing season for Jorge Lorenzo. He's just come up against a phenomenon. He's just come up against perhaps the biggest thing we've ever seen in Grand Prix motorcycle racing.
Next year, I'll be back, and I'm sure he will. If he can get through the season injury-free, then he'll be there. He'll be making it hard for Marquez to retain the crown. Here he goes, up towards the Marquez badge, had a casualty. Rider down.
Cameraman down.
There he is, look at this. The fans going wild up there. And who can blame them? He's done the job, done the business.
That's going to be total chaos now. He's going to throw his gloves in the crowd, I think, isn't he? It will be a prized possession, won't they? Well done, Marc Marquez. Start of the season, we thought two Grand Prix wins, perhaps. It's going to be a great year. He's absolutely confounded us all.
But the Hulk Hogan's there for Marc Marquez as well, as he lobs his gloves into the crowd. Is the helmet going to go as well, Pat?
It may do. It's coming off.
Someone's going to get a lucky prize there, golly, perhaps, yeah. If it does. Maybe he's got a special helmet to give away, or to show us as world champion. Everyone will want a piece of Marquez, not just here, but across the world, across the sporting world.
We've seen some great world champions in Grand Prix motorcycle racing, ones that have won 15 world titles, 9 world titles. This is the third for Marc Marquez, but you've got to say, there's many, many more to come for this young man.
Special scenes in a special year for Marc Marquez. He has broken records left, right and centre throughout this season. I'd love to go through them because we have got about 4 pages.
We'd be here for the start of next season.
Exactly, we'd be all the way through winter testing. There's your box, Nick. There's all those T-shirts. Nakamoto checking he's got the right size.
So, no disrespect, they're so Japanese when he wanted to make sure he had the right size T-shirt to wear for the world champion.
And but the main ones, of course, Marquez is the first rookie to win since Kenny Roberts in 1978.
I think that's Jorge Lorenzo.
They get to a burnout in the final race, don't they? I don't think he'll be fined 20,000 euros for that one, will he?
No.
Take that, Sebastian Vettel.
Brilliant, brilliant ride by Jorge Lorenzo. It's won the last 3 races. He brought this championship right down to the wire. Honestly, I don't think he could have done any more than what he has done. Well done, Jorge Lorenzo. Roll on 2014.
Yeah, Marquez as well. There he is, getting all the new stickers, T-shirt, helmet, everything on his bike. Of course, youngest ever winner now of MotoGP. But he's also another record that puts him up with some of the true greats of the sport. Just the 4th rider in 65 years of MotoGP, all the way back to 1949 to now, only 3 other riders have won three different categories of championship. I'll get there eventually. Mike Hailwood, Phil Reed, and Valentino Rossi. A baby champ on board. he is. He's still just a kid.
Well done, Dad.
He's been put through the ringer this season. Yeah. He's done well to make it to the end.
I tell you what, he deserves a special T-shirt for himself. Congratulations, salute the 2013 world champion.
Top CRT, yet again, Aleix Espargaró. He ends the job with the Aspar team before he moves on to pastures new with Forward Racing and the FTR Yamaha next year in the open class.
Difficult now for Jorge Lorenzo. He's got to wait, of course, for the return of Marc Marquez.
I didn't quite see there whether there was any altercation or any words between Lorenzo and Pedrosa. knees going down for Marc Márquez. He doesn't actually take the track. This is the escape route that he's going through to make sure he's closest as he can be to the fans. He's going to go off onto the grass, look. Oh, just into the gravel. Thank goodness that didn't happen during the race.
An hour ago, that would have caused a few problems, wouldn't it? We can smell the tyre that has been burnt out by Jorge Lorenzo in our box.
He did do it right outside your box.
I can smell it, yeah.
I was going to blame you, Nick.
They usually do. Congratulations, Marc Márquez. What a breath of fresh air in the championship. Did it need a breath of fresh air? If it did or not, it certainly got it.
Well, who cares? It has lit up the year. Alvaro Bautista takes fifth place. He says back next year he is on that bike. New teammate in Scott Redding, of course. They'll all be out testing tomorrow. Yamaha delaying their testing by the sounds of things until Tuesday. Ducati will be out, of course, with Cal Crutchlow on board that bike for the first time. You can get all the latest live testing on the MotoGP website as well, as the world champion comes back into Parc Fermé to celebrate with his team for the first time.
Marc Márquez, 2013 world champion. Repsol Honda have won the team award. Honda have won the constructors award. It does not get better than that.
He's off. He's gone. I'll let them enjoy it again and again. He will laugh and laugh long into the night. He won't stop it. There's Santi Hernandez. Oh, it's great to see, isn't it? That just outpouring of emotion.
His third world championship, 20 years old. Where will it end? Where were we? What were we going to be saying in 10 years' time about him? I think Emilio Elsamora is there now after tears before even the end of the race for his great mentor that's seen him all the way through. Oh, and there's another Márquez as well that's beginning to show great promise in his younger brother, Alex.
Livio Supo gets a big hug as well. He's overseen the World Championships now for Stoner at Repsol Honda and now for Marc Márquez as well. Team don't know where to turn, do they?
No, they don't, in their celebration.
I'm sure you'll get a congratulations as well from Pedrosa and from Lorenzo too.
I'm sure he will. He probably just wants
here
to...
We are.
There we go. Yeah, well done, Jorge Lorenzo.
That's great.
Brilliant.
Great to see, isn't it? One outgoing world champion handing on the baton to the new world champ.
Dad, he just will...
Been there every single race, every single practice.
We'll take it in. We'll not make a great fuss. If things go badly, things go well. Valentino Rossi looks absolutely... Well, he didn't look gutted, but he does not look happy at all. And there's Jerry Burgess alongside him. Yeah. And it's farewell. Well, we see celebrations in one part of the paddock, the sad day in other.
Tears flowing there for
his dad.
Julian Márquez. There's Nakamoto.
He's got the right size, is he? Yeah, he's all right.
He's got the big smile on his face, hasn't he? Keeps it generally under wraps. There's Danny Pedrosa. A few people say that those two don't get on. I tell you, it's not as frosty as some people suggest. I can promise you that after witnessing them out together 2 weeks ago in Japan. And I'm sure they'll be partying just as hard later on tonight at the awards ceremony.
Fourth place, Valentino Rossi, fourth in the championship, of course, on his comeback year with Yamaha. But he hasn't been, he'll be the first to say he can't run at the moment with those top three, can he? He hasn't got the pace there to do it.
Alex Márquez is asking if we're on TV, if we're live. Yes, we are. And it's live around the world, showing your brother is the new MotoGP world champion.
Oh, Lorenzo talking to Italian television. I think that's Alessio Spargaro, isn't it? Top CRT man once again. Big hug for the new world champion.
Time for a few interviews. I expect they won't be the last of the next few days and weeks and months.
I think the music's going to start, the band will start.
I'm sure soon enough we're going to get the fireworks as well going off around the circuit. Is that just after the podium they come? I can't remember.
I think they usually do.
Usually
you certainly know when they come. Says it all, number one on that Repsol Honda, Smart Marquez, number 93. What a rookie season for the 20-year-old. Astounding.
What a setting for it as well here at Valencia. 104,000 fans packed in. They told us they're going to get over 90,000 in here now.
I don't know where the others came from.
Just cram them in like sardines. Yeah. Jorge Lorenzo, of course, won the race. There is an investigation pending that move on Dani Pedrosa earlier on, but he did light it up with some excitement in those early laps. Pedrosa second, of course, and Marc Marquez in third, cruising home. Rossi was fourth, Bautista fifth. He saw Bradle and Smith sixth and seventh. Hayden Topnicati in his last ride for the Italian factory. Dovizioso ninth, Pirro rounding out the top 10. There's Espargaro as the top CRT in 11th place. Right down to Colin Edwards, who rounds out the points. He will stay on with that team for next season.
Wow, what a year it's been. I hope you've enjoyed it wherever you've been watching and listening as much as we have. It has been an amazing season in all three classes.
Yeah, absolutely stunning. Great for Spain, of course. They celebrate with three world champions. And it's probably they're going to be around there again, but there'll be other riders want to just get involved in that battle at the top, not just in MotoGP, but across Moto2 and Moto3 as well.
4 points in the end, just four little points separating Marquez and Lorenzo. What a battle it was. The unfortunate Dani Pedrosa in third place, Rossi and then Crutchlow. Bautista in sixth, Bradle seven, Dovizioso, Nicky Hayden, and Bradley Smith completing that top 10 in the World Championship. Yeah. And Aleix Espargaró, as we said, top CRT.
Yeah, he's done a fantastic season. Espargaró, once more, as we say, will go on to Forward Racing. We send our farewells, of course, to Ben Spies, who retired earlier on this season, and wish him well for the future. It was a sad end to his stellar career as well. And that's going to be it. That's the 18th round of the championship. But it all begins again tomorrow. No need to worry. If you want to see more bikes, there's testing action starting tomorrow as well. We'll be live with that for you directly from here in Valencia as well. And then it just rumbles on. We're in 2014 already.
And would you believe?
I don't want to forget this just yet.
Though when those floodlights were switched on in Qatar, that opening round of the season, how this would end up.
Well, we got an idea, didn't we, the way Marquez tried to rough up Rossi in that opening round, that he wasn't going to come into this championship lying down.
Certainly wasn't. It's been an amazing championship and such relief, the Repsol Honda team, Sandy Hernandez, his crew chief in particular, after everything that happened in Australia. Just 3 weeks ago, that was all going on.
Time to perhaps take a breather. That's the end of another great season of MotoGP. I think you're right in saying he's breathed some extra new life into the championship.
Guys, I'm just down here with Livio Supo. Livio, back in Qatar, could you have imagined a day such as this?
Not really. I mean, it's been unbelievable all season, very constant, not only fast, but super constant. Every race he finished, he was on the podium, so unbelievable, really.
What did you make of Lorenzo's tactics slowing down the race at the start?
I think it was the only thing he can do, not only win, but try to create some confusion. I think sometimes he went very close to the limit, but that's racing, as far as they don't accompany when he's the opposite side.
Great, thank you very much.
Pointing that one out, isn't he? Yeah, that's racing, but don't come crying to us next time.
There you go, this team's championship. Repsol Honda have won that one as well. It's been one hell of a season for them. Obviously, the Yamaha factory team in second place, and a very good year for the Monster Yamaha Tech 3 team. With Cal Crutchlow, who departs to Ducati, and Bradley Smith, who's had an excellent rookie season.
Yeah, he'll be joined by Paul Espargaró, who'll be riding that bike on Tuesday, we understand. That Yamaha won't be testing tomorrow as they get everything put together. Same for Forward Racing. They're looking to get going tomorrow. They've got to work long into the night to try and get their bikes ready. But we understand the Honda customer bikes will be out there tomorrow, come what may. There's Gerard Piquet, the FC Barcelona player and Spanish World Cup champion, of course, as well.
Is he pulling his beard?
Giving him a grab of the cheek.
That is so Marquez, though, isn't it? Yeah. He's That's really good as well. And Jarvis, the head of a Yamaha Racing, just shaking his hand and saying, well done. We've already seen Lorenzo do that. Boy, it's rough and tough off the on the track, but off the track, enormous respect by everybody. But here he is. He's the 2013 MotoGP World Champion. He's totally rewritten all the history books, all the records you could imagine. What a season it's been for Marc Márquez.
Someone's dropped their phone down and
look at that.
Oh no! Oh no, it's in pieces now.
Oh,
someone's obviously not played cricket before up there.
He's laughing and smiling already.
My phone was broken by Marc Márquez.
Yeah, I think that would go down. Pretty couldn't film it really, wasn't it, on his phone. So here we go. Emotional podium, a historical podium. An amazing season, and what a finish. Those first 10 laps, as good as you'd want to see at any level of motorsport, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 wheels, whatever you want.
Get Danny Pedrosa showing off how much rubber of Jorge Lorenzo has
left on his leathers.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Said both sides, you know.
I've been looking after you.
Yeah.
Like my younger brother, isn't it?
That's what they're saying, Matt was saying. I wasn't being dragged into it. But Danny's a little bit annoyed.
He's not happy, is he? You can see that. And your interview with him will be quite interesting in a minute. Oh, Márquez coming out first, is he, as world champion?
Well,
finishing third, of course.
Yeah. Baby on board. Yeah, fabulous stuff for Marc. And the family as well, all down there to celebrate with him.
Yeah, very close family as well, aren't they? So where did we see his granddad at one of the Grand Prix? I think it was Aragon, was it?
Yeah. I remember a shot from the Repsol Honda team launch at the beginning of the year, who was showing his granddad around the bike.
That's right. That's what I was watching. Sorry, yeah.
Yeah, all the little bits and bobs do.
Yeah.
Third place trophy was almost about to be given there to Danny Pedrosa, but it's to Jorge Lorenzo. No, it's to Marc Márquez, of course.
Yeah, third place to Marc Márquez.
He won't care about not having won the race at all.
No, of course he won't. And Danny Pedrosa in second place, still a little bit aggrieved and still a few tire marks on his leathers after an amazing opening 10 laps, as fierce as you'd ever want to see with Jorge Lorenzo. And the race winner is his 8th Grand Prix win of the season, but he stands on the top step of the podium, but he is not the world champion anymore. But what a fight. 4 points at the finish separated him and Marc Márquez.
The 17th time this year, the Spanish national anthem rings around the MotoGP paddock. Lorenzo is customary leap off the podium as well. And I think they might enjoy this spraying of the champagne. Lynn Jarvis getting a covering from Jorge Lorenzo, but the party's already started. Save some of that champagne, Mark.